Well, hey everybody, my name is Nathaniel Dodson from tutvid.com. Welcome into the very first ever Adobe XD tutorial that I'm doing on this channel, and I thought there was no better way to kick off the Adobe XD tutorials than to show you the feature that it's the feature that I first noticed when I first picked up and started playing with Adobe XD. And as I was making this tutorial, I really don't know how I've gone this long without making an Adobe XD tutorial. It's just one of those apps that's so simple and beautiful and powerful and amazing in so many different ways. It's like, dude, how have you not made a video about this yet? To which my answer is, I don't know. But now, we're going to rectify that. And today we're going to talk about the thing that I noticed when I first picked up and started playing with Adobe XD, and that is the repeating grid. It's amazing and powerful and wonderful in so many different ways. You just gotta see it. Now, if you do enjoy this tutorial, make sure you subscribe to my channel so you never miss another video tutorial in the future. Let's jump into XD right now. And, it's gonna be a little bit of baptism by fire, so let's go. Here we are in Adobe XD for the first time ever on this channel. I'm pumped. This is the very first feature, as I've said a number of times now, the very first feature that I remember seeing and hearing about in Adobe XD that got me really excited to start playing with this application when it first came out. It's something that's just a little different. You can't do this in Photoshop or InDesign or Illustrator, as far as I know. So let's kick this off here by opening up the Layers panel down here. And I'm going to select the Team Artboard. I've got this kind of beginner XD application. Maybe I can share it. I'll see if I can package this up and share it as a download link that may be down in the bio of this video if I can get it all sorted out. But I'm going to select the Team Artboard here. And then over in the Properties panel, I'm going to tick on the grid. And I'm going to set it to 10 pixels per cell size just to keep things kind of standard and normal here. Next, I'm going to use the Ellipse tool over here. And I'm going to drag out a perfect circle by holding down the Shift key, and I'm going to keep an eye on my Properties panel because I want a 120 by 120 pixel circle here. I will dump the border by unchecking the border option over in the Properties panel, and then I'm going to copy and paste this circle onto my artboard. I'm going to use the size options in my Properties panel to boost this second circle, the one we just copied, to 140 by 140 pixels. I'm going to get rid of the fill on this one, and I'm going to give this one a 1 pixel stroke. The 1 pixel stroke, by the way, it's going to be white. And then lastly, I'm going to use the alignment tools to just line these shapes up, align them horizontally and vertically with one another. And I will select that outer stroke, the white outer stroke that we just created, and I'm going to reduce its opacity to 20%, again, over in the Properties panel. The fill of the original ellipse, it can be any color you want. I'm just going to leave it as this sort of default white here. Next, I'm going to grab the text tool, and I'm going to type out the words name, placeholder, and then I'm going to select this bit of text and look to the Properties panel. I'm going to choose the font SF Pro Text, and I'm going to set it to a 26 size with a semi-bold weight, and I'm going to make sure I align this text to the center over here, and I'll also set the fill of the text to a solid white. Now I'm going to use the hotkey Command or Control plus apostrophe to shut off the grid temporarily, just so I can drag this piece of type around, and eventually I'll see this smart guide appear that'll let me know I've aligned this text perfectly to the exact center of my double circle. Use these smart guides again and just drag the text down until it sort of clicks to the bottom of the double circle. And then go ahead and hit Command or Control plus the apostrophe key to turn the grid on again. I'm going to go grab some Ipsum from Lipsum.com. There's a bajillion and a half Ipsum or Lipsum generators out there. I'm just going to copy some and come back here into XD. And I'll drag out another text field and paste in a bit of the Ipsum that I just copied. I'm going to commit these changes by hitting Command plus the return key, or on the Windows machine, this would be Control Enter. I'm going to align this text to the center and make sure it's SF Pro Text font as well. I'm going to change the size to 20, and I'm going to set the weight to light. I'll also reduce the opacity of this text to 50%. So the text is still white, but because it's set to 50% opacity, it's just going to appear a little more subtle. Set the width of this text field to 340 pixels, and then we'll just set the height to 80 pixels. I'm going to shut off the grid once more, and I'm just going to slide and adjust and move the text until it aligns center with the text above it, as well as the smart guides will give me the perfect spacing from the bottom of the headline to the top of this sort of tagline text as well. It's a helpful little feature here in Adobe XD. Next, I'm going to grab the line tool, and I'm going to start dragging a line downward from 3 grid cells above the circle all the way through 3 grid cells below the bottom of the text box here. Now I'm going to drag this line. I want to move it a little bit to the right of these circles and the text fields. I'm going to make sure the line basically is 10 cells to the right of the outer circle ring. So if I count these little cells, I can see that there's going to be 10 of them between the outer circle ring to this vertical stroke that I just created. Now I'm going to make sure the stroke is set to the color of white, and I'm just going to reduce the opacity of it to 20%. Now the next step is going to be to select all these pieces of artwork that we just created and hit Command or Control G to group all this stuff together. Now here's where the magic happens. With this group selected, go ahead and hit the Repeat Grid button in the Properties panel and drag the fat node in the middle right all the way across your screen until you see four of these bio packages, if you will, and drag the fat node on the bottom center of this whole thing downward to get a second row. Then find the pink vertical gutters. If you hover over, you'll see the pink vertical gutters appear, and increase the width of these from the default 20 pixels to 30 pixels. And then find the horizontal pink gutter and just drag it to reduce it down to zero. You'll see, you'll get a little heads-up display that tells you how many pixels of width are there. We want there to be zero on the horizontal. Next, select this entire group, this entire sort of repeat grid group, and use the alignment tools over in the properties panel to center this group horizontally and vertically here within our artboard. And adjust the vertical alignment a little bit. We can nudge the whole group up or down until it looks just right. Horizontally, we'll be lined up nicely. Vertically, you might need to make a little adjustments. Now here's where things become magical all over again. We can add our team's photos, these eight white circles. We can add our team's photos to these by just jumping out to the Finder. I've got eight photos of people here. I can just drag them off of my hard drive and drop them on the first circle. And XD is intelligent enough to know that both we want this circle to automatically mask our image, and also that each of the remaining photos will go to a remaining circle in this sequence of groups. It's really pretty cool. But wait, there's another neat trick or two that XD has up its sleeve for us as well. We can take a .txt file. Check this out. I've got this .txt file. It's got a bunch of names in it, each on its own line. And I can drag this .txt file, plain text file. It's important that it's plain text. And simply drop that file on that name placeholder text field. And it's going to add the name for each of these team members. I also have a .txt file with some bio, just random bio info from gridlover.net. I just filled in some random information for these team members. And I can drop this right onto the first text field for the bios. And you can see each line of data is going to go for one bio. So just like that, we filled out eight bios easier than you could ever imagine. It really is quite remarkable. So one simple drop of a .txt file onto that text field, you can watch your text flow right through the entire document as well. So satisfying, and it absolutely never gets old. So that's it for this one, folks. I hope you've learned something a little new about Adobe XD. Maybe you're ready to crack open Adobe XD for the first time yourself, and if you do, I'm so excited for you. You're going to love it. I think I'm going to start trying to introduce a couple of these Adobe XD tutorials every month here into the channel and satisfy my hunger pangs for a little bit of web design, UI design. We can have a lot of fun with this application. There's a lot of really, 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 really cool stuff you can do with it. And that was a lot of reallys that I just dropped there. So for playing around with the simple UI interface and the repeating grid and crazy stuff with text files and images and what in the world? Just the crazy power of the repeating grid all over again. Guys, for this one, that's it. Get it? Got it? Good. Nathaniel Dodson, tutvid.com. I'll catch you in the next one. And before you go, make sure you subscribe to my channel for more great tutorials every day. Also, buy my course. It helps us do what we do, and this channel is supported by viewers just like you. You can also just click the thumbnail and watch another video from this channel. See you next time, guys.